If your face turned red after drinking a bit of alcohol, I bet you are likely a Chinese, and the redness is not because your skin is pale. Watch out and you understand. So, some of us think that everyone's face will turn red after they drink alcohol, and it's therefore more obvious if you have paler skin. That's incorrect, because if you have been to Haji Reng at night, you'll see more drinking, and then their face likely didn't even turn red at all. Some of us, especially the older folks, think that those whose face turn red are healthier, because it means that alcohol is being digested fast, which is why their face turn red so fast. That's incorrect too, because alcohol can't even be digested like food, you bodo. So, why do some of us turn red? It's because some of us do not have a working enzyme called aldehyde dehydrogenase 2, also called ALDH2. Now, I'm going to simplify everything. So if you want the chim version, check out the 3 links I link in the description of this video in our YouTube version lah. You see, for a start, the alcohol in an alcoholic drink, which is technically called ethanol, isn't digested like the Big Mac you have just eaten, but broken down instead. Your body only digests the other ingredients in your alcoholic drinks, like the sugar sucrose. Instead, when ethanol is consumed, it's broken down into acetaldehyde, a toxic substance that can cause symptoms like flushing, nausea, and headaches. This is a byproduct, and usually, the enzyme ALDH2 breaks down acetaldehyde into a harmless substance. However, without ALDH2, acetaldehyde accumulates in our bodies, leading to the red face and other symptoms. Cause remember, it's like having a party in your room, and not being able to throw away all the rubbish, which is acetaldehyde, out of the room. Eventually, it will be thrown away, but very slowly. Here's the interesting thing, because this is a genetic deficiency, this means this is passed down from our parents to us, which explains why only a certain group of people have this. And yeah, you've guessed it right. It's many of people of East Asia, with up to 50% of Chinese, Japanese, or Koreans having this genetic deficiency. By now, you should be wondering, is this the same issue that caused us to be drunk? The short answer is no. When you are drunk, it's because ethanol is affecting your brain directly. To use the same analogy, when you are drunk, it's not because of the rubbish in the room. Instead, just think of a flying cockroach flying into the room. Everyone in the room will go crazy with the cockroach, similar to how Gombira will go crazy after she is drunk. While both the rubbish and cockroach are unwelcome and will affect people in the room, they are different things altogether. So how do you know that you have got this genetic deficiency, or if you are just drunk? Hey, Bodo, if you need to know if you are drunk or not, then you shouldn't drink at all. Now, let me scare you a bit. Remember the rubbish that I was talking about? Yeah, it's not good. When you have the rubbish too long in your body, your risk of esophageal cancer is up to 10 times higher than someone who doesn't have that rubbish too long. That is if you drink 2 beers a day, which you really shouldn't do in the first place. That rubbish itself is carcinogenic, which means it has the potential to cause cancer. Now, what are the solutions? Let me ask you, how do I make myself look like Andy Lau or my wife to look like Cai Ling? You cannot, as that depends solely on our genes. So similarly, there's nothing much you can do except to drink in moderation. Now, do you know that this is pretty much similar to why we need to wear glasses? Watch this and you understand. And also, thank you for spending almost 3 minutes with me. I really appreciate it. I hope that you learned something.